on my story today. We took a trip to Abaji, one of the area councils in the Federal Capital Territory FCT, Abuja. We were at the palace of His Royal Highness, Alhaji Dr. Adamu Baba Yunusa, the owner of Abaji. He took us through the historical background of this ancient town, the culture and beliefs. And we also bring you the stories of Nathan Dodo and Janeth Member Kaatyo, who after venturing into several businesses and different employments, now find fulfillment in wealth creation venture, financial empowerment, interviews. So please stay tuned, as today's episode promises to be educative and inspiring.
I started my primary school in 1962. I passed out in 1969. I got married in 1973. Had my first issue in 1976. Then I went back to school. This was at UP in 1997. Then I passed out in 1982. I have my U2 certificate. At present, I have 4 wives and have many children. My late brother was Alhaji Baba Yunusa. And he has 4 wives too. So, and our occupation was farming. We were farming, we were a farmer, we do everything. And we are from the single family. We have many brothers, we have many sisters, and all of them are living in the same compound. Moreover, our religion is Islam. We are all Muslims in my family. All of us are Muslims. And most of our women, they whipped clothes. They are, some of them are, some of them go to the farm to come fetch firewood, water, and other things. But the major occupation for our female is weaving. They weave clothes, they wear the clothes, and at the same time, there is the occupation, because there's so many of the clothes. This is where they survive. In our area of farming, what we planted the guinea corn, that is sorghum, planted this, beans, millet, yam, rice, and that and sweet potato. We also planted this bene seed. Even this calabash is one of those that we planted in our farm. So it's through this farming that most of our people earn their living. Even not now that they have white collar job. That people go to with this government work and other things. This is what we are doing, and this is our occupation, and this is what we do. The first person to settle in Abaji, his name is Abaji. The first person to settle is Igwe. But traditionally, it's called Igabazi. Igabazi means that the fence, the fence around the Abaji. That is, when you have that Abaji fence itself, that is called Igabazi. Igami fence. It's the first settler for this Abaji. And we're from Ogidi. As I mentioned, they have Aniku. It's another clan. Then they have Ategema. These are the three you know, have that settled in Abaji. Abaji is the gateway to LCT. We come from the start. We come through Abaji before they enter LCT. And we have many tribes in Abaji. The original inhabitant of Abaji, the Igwiras, that the first settlers, then followed by Hausas, followed by Ganaganas, followed by Nupis, followed by Aguchi, Aluchi, and other tribes. They have Gwali, they have Basa, settled later, and all work together. And we rub man together, we do everything together and come.
After our encounter with His Royal Highness, we also visited this uncompleted and abandoned institution of higher learning, Abuja University of Technology, Abaji. According to security personnel in the abandoned property, Mr. Simon Marcus and Joshua Daudu, this project has been abandoned since 2012.
I was employed from this place as casual staff from 2011 to 2017 up to date. And the school is not here open. The project in staff everywhere here is abandoned. And we have been crying for the minister to open the school for us. Then start this school from 2011, the project in this place. From that 2011, working to 2012, then 13, everything starting to be low. Till 2014, everything switch off. Till now, they have built hostel and laboratory and uncompleted multipurpose and classes, including some staff quarters. Yet they have not opened the school up to date, including the security that are working here for past as a casual staff for past 7 years now. We have not been employed. We have not given a permanent appointment, and we have suffered because of that.
I'm Joshua Daudu Tukura. Born and brought up from Abaji town, and I'm a security man in University of Abuja in technology, Abaji. I want you people to go and grant my request to the followers. Number one, the President of Federal Republic of Nigeria, the Vice President of Federal Republic of Nigeria, the Senate President of Federal Republic of Nigeria, the Speaker of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, the Minister of FCT Abuja, State Minister of FCT Abuja, Senator of FCT Abuja, and then the House of Rep of FCT Abuja. Why did I mention those people? It is that a tree cannot make a forest. I'm saying that they should grant my request. It is that I was being employed since 1st year 2011. I'm hereby as a security man. As I'm a security man here, all the time I'm there in the gate. I'm at the gate alert. And likewise, my children usually come for looking for admission in this school because they usually had news that they are going to commission the school. When they come, I'll tell them they should go back yet. They should forward it to the table of the President of Federal Republic of Nigeria and the other people that I mentioned, they are going to sit down because look at things are wasting. Look at the houses are wasting. You have gate inside, you have seen the environment. You have seen the structures. Please, kindly, they should kindly clean my tears so that they should commission the school for us. We are ready to read and learn. I'm being attacked by robbers, sir, as a security man. Those robbers are Fulani people that came me here to come and steal. Then they were attacking me. They, after attacking me, this is how my neck was being cut, above the hand. The fingers, they cannot move. And the bone here cannot, it is yet to be joined. I was the only person there that went there to go and verify how things are moving there. They were up here at the admin block. That's what happened.
Coming up.
Over 400 people have partnered with us, and we are moving a lot of businesses in line of financial empowerment.
And this is my story.
This is my story.
Life forever. Baba God bless you, no go pass you by. He go bless you, so tell them go ask you.
Your kada, you know what I say, you know go drive home. Everybody just help your water. You know what I say, I like the for better. But I'm still a plant and mine. I'm really making my life.
My name is Nathan Dodo, born to the family of Mr. and Mrs. Ademu Dodo. Some years back, actually on 22nd August 1979, in a little town of Kafanchan in Kaduna State, my childhood was quite interesting because I had a bit of both worlds, that is, the good and the bad. I grew up with my grandmother because actually my mom was in school. So I grew up knowing my grandmother as my mom, as we used to call her then, Na. So up to the age of 6, when I had to leave the village for the city, as it were then, I started primary school. Concluded primary school and went to secondary school. While in primary school, I was always the determined type. I wanted to make something out of life. Knowing where I came from, coming from the village, having to compete with those in the city, I always had to polish my English or polish my sentences before they come out. But eventually, being a determined person, I caught up with my peer groups and actually surpassed. From primary 3, that was when I actually came first in my class. And since then, it has always been the norm. Up to primary 6, I was selected out of 3 students in the secondary school to represent my school for the Gifted Children's Program in Suleja, Niger State. So we're actually the third set that started the Gifted program in Suleja Academy, then it was called. It is now Federal Government Academy. That also challenged me. That was my secondary school days. You know, when you're in secondary school, the idea is always, I want to be a doctor, I want to be a lawyer, I want to be an engineer. Mine was being an engineer, but it was not to be, as I was given admission to study veterinary medicine. So I started veterinary medicine in 1999. Geography was what I wanted to study because I love environment, I love the nature, and I actually want to make the environment better. So I went to geography and actually came out with a second class upper degree, which was like a feat for my set at that time because it was difficult for a transfer student to actually come out with a second class upper degree. But I achieved that in my final year, which actually was a commendable thing to my lecturers and to my peers. Coming out of the university, I felt that I should work for a company that would add value to my life. I had the opportunity of working with several companies, Globalcom Nigeria Limited. I worked with Guinness Nigeria PLC. I worked with checky.com.ng in recent times, but in all of it, I discovered there was more to life than just giving, 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 and you needed to build something that would stand the test of time, which got me into self-awareness that financial empowerment is something that I needed to go into. We teach people how to develop themselves and to empower themselves from nothing getting up to that level where you want to be. Because in life, everybody desires of something better. And that is what we have been doing, which is what brought us to setting up a company. The name of the business, we tagged it Financial Empowerment Interbiz. We came a set of partners, we partnered and started that empowerment for a lot of other people like me who were not satisfied with where they were. And so far so good, we have a number of people under our umbrella who are also determined to make money. Over 400 people have partnered with us, and we are moving a lot of businesses in line of financial empowerment. So far so good, we are building people to take up leadership positions through earning money, because if you are financially stable, you would be able to take care of a lot of other things. So that's my story.
My name is Janeth Mimbe Kaatyo. I'm from Benue State. We local government to be precise, a lady. I was born on 13th of April, 1985. I grew up in the village, a lady. I went to my primary and secondary school in the village. Growing up in the remote part of the country, like the village, with the education I had, I've always wanted to be a successful person. Even though the chances of becoming a successful person were lean, because I grew up in an environment whereby girls are easily influenced with the peer pressure. Before they attend the age of 18, they get pregnant one way or the other, they get married. And my secondary school days, I remember I had about 6 friends, and I can tell you that all of them could not make it out of secondary school. They all got pregnant, got married, have kids before they even attained the age of 18. My mom always tells me that if I get pregnant, she's gonna get me married to an old man in one remote village. I don't even have to see the main road. But my dream as a girl, even when I was small, was to graduate from the university and get a job and work in an office. These were my dreams as a young girl. This actually helped me to put myself together and finish my secondary school. And after my secondary school, my elder sister was already working here in Abuja, and I had the opportunity of leaving the village to stay with her in Abuja. So when I moved into Abuja, I begin to think that my dreams are beginning to come to a reality. Then after some 2 or 3 years, I got admission to the Polytechnic to study business administration. I did the national diploma. After that, I went for the higher national diploma, which I graduated. In the year 2009, I went for my NYSE. It is a dream for every young person out there after their university education to get a job. But after you've graduated from the university, you have done your mandatory NYSC service, you find out that to get a job in Nigeria today is not as easy as it is today. I tried my hands on few jobs, tried a lot of applications. Some you were even called for interview. At the end of the day, you don't even get to hear feedback. So after I tried all these areas, I said, okay, I have to try business, which I went into business as well. I tried also, even in business, I tried my hands on few businesses, buying and selling. In fact, during my NYC, I was buying and selling clothes from Lagos. After my NYC, I even went into bedsheet and duvet business, which in fact, up till now, some people are still owing me from all those businesses. They buy from you, oh, don't worry, I'll pay you next month. But at the end of the day, you keep chasing people from one place to the other for your money, and they look at you as like an enemy. Somebody who buys something from you, and you get for you to get your money, it becomes as if you are a bad person for selling that business, whereby your money stocks here and there. So after all this, I said, what am I going to do? I think of diverting my attention to other businesses. Now my success story is networking business. Now, networking business gives you the opportunity to invest a little amount of money and leverage on the effort of the team members, whereby you can earn even millions of naira with a little amount of investment. It's been fantastic working with Igu Oron Company, hence my success story. So for every young person out there who is at the verge of losing hope, because of the current economic situation, this is my advice for you out there. Here we present an opportunity for you to invest a little amount of money, and we work as a team for you to succeed, and together we will have more success stories to tell together.
After telling us their stories, we took a trip to Amadon Plaza, where Financial Empowerment Interbiz is located, a company co-founded by Nathan and Janeth. And he took us through the processes involved in investing with them.
Our own name is Financial Empowerment Interbiz, and the business we're running with is Eagle Oram Company. This is a business on gold and silver where you start up with a capital of 40 euros and earn to 1 million euros. This is a typical presentation. We tell people that we are a group of corporate individuals who work to build networks capable of generating residual income through team effort. Once you partner with us, we work to ensure you get value for your efforts and that of others. With FEI, you are guaranteed return on your investments. Why? Because networking requires downlines, and we build those downlines for you. Now, this is the name of the company we are into. The name is Eagle Oram Company. This company is actually based in Spain. It's a fully registered company. You can see their fiscal identification code here. Anybody can actually do business with them legally. They have offices globally, and the owner of the business is actually Alejandro Raul Ajila. He has 5 board of directors. Adil Gazmala is the person in charge of the Arabian and African countries. These are their products. They actually have the physical gold and silver coins, and then the bars. So when you earn your money, you can choose to collect it or request for these precious metals. This is their cycle. It's in cycles of 12. You start with 40 euros. 40 euros now earns you 212 euros. After 12 people are added under you, you need 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. That closes your first cycle. That earns you 212 euros. 150 is deducted, leaving you 62 euros. That is what pays you the first payment that you can take home with. The second level earns you 790 euros, 580 is deducted, you are left with 210. Of course, you will also be paid this 212 completely. The third cycle earns you 3,000 euros and 2,200 will be deducted, leaving you 800 euros. The fourth cycle earns you 12,000 euros, 9,500 will be deducted, leaving you 2,500. The fifth cycle earns you 53,000 euros, leaving you 40,000 will be deducted, of course, leaving you 13,000. The sixth cycle, which is the second to the last, earns you 219,000 euros and 171 will be deducted, leaving you 58,000 euros, leading you to this millionaire's club, which is the seventh and final stage where you would earn a total of 1 million euros. Now, with Eagle Oram Company, you earn in 7 stages. This is the tabular representation of the earnings. We have earned the first level and the second level. The third level is on the process of being earned. Now, what we do is the referrals for people in stages. Once you partner with us, we work to ensure that you get value for your money. You can make your withdrawal actually through your bank account, or you withdraw the gold in precious metals. This is the amount to sign up with us. 45,000 naira with Eagle Oram Company. This is actually the website of the company, www.eagleoram.com. I was paid on 14th November, my second earning of 366 euros. You can see it here. This is Eagle Oram Company has effected a transfer for 366 euros in favor of myself, Dodo, Nath, and Adamu to my GTB account. I was actually credited 2 days later on the 16th of November with the same amount. I went to withdraw the money in cash and I have the euros to show for it. The truth is that everybody wants to make money, but you need a strategy that actually works, which is what Financial Empowerment Interbiz offers. These are our contact details for those who want to actually get in touch with us. For further inquiries, you can call us on our numbers 080-3055-9741 and 090-6638-9257. For Janeth,
you can contact me on 080-3584-9809. Again, another number 090-6638-9284.
And that's it on My Story today. For your comments and suggestions, please send a text or WhatsApp message to 0806-004-2843. Thank you for staying tuned.